Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Pokemon Ranger Shadows of Almia. Last time, we did some more quests. We got assigned to go on patrol and decided to take on quests on that patrol. And this time we're reporting back to Chairperson Irma, right up here. Keith went with us that entire time too, so we get to spend some time with him. Hello, have you finished patrolling?
Yup.
Please drop by the research room too.
Oh. Okay.
Are you gonna be down there? Are you gonna magically have teleported down there? Because I can definitely see that happening. Let's see. This isn't the research room, is it? Where's the research room again? I don't know my way around this place. Is it this one? Should really have signs outside. This is not the research room, is it? Okay. Where the heck are we going? I mean, I guess that they're probably researching the stuff that they brought back, right? I mean, did we even bring any dark crystals back? I don't remember. Here we go. Fashion Keith! Oh yeah, the book. I completely forgot about the book we brought back. Keep your voices down. No shouting, ever. We do not want to disturb the fellows deciphering that diary. Sorry, that was a hiccup. Murph's sunny character uplifts me. He seems to take the edge off of things. Oh, now what is this? There are some letters starting to emerge on the cover. Brighton? Brighton? What do you suppose that could be? Fash! I've heard of Brighton before. When I first met you in the lobby of the Ultra Building. What was it now? Oh wait, don't tell me. Was it a new kind of candy? Brighton. Is that the name of a new soda for whitening teeth? You should hustle to the Ultra Building. That's what you should do. Like Murph said, we might learn something by going to the Ultra Building. Wasn't that one of the former presidents of the company? Is that what it was? I guess we'll find out. We're fairly close to Altru. I mean, we're probably still gonna catch Staraptor and fly there. This is gonna be just a little bit quicker than walking. Here we are! Thank you, Staraptor! Alright, let's go. We can just waltz on in here. Hello? Yo, is Isaac around? Welcome to Altru Inc. Here on the ground floor, we have exhibits on the history of Altru Inc. From the second floor and up, the building is off-limits to the public. Okay. An undersea oil field exploration device developed 25 years ago. We also have a scale model of the Altru Tower from its announcement event 3 years ago. Tools used for digging oil wells 70 years ago. A lady. Altru struck oil using equipment this crude 50 years ago. It's still more advanced than equipment from 70 years ago, but... Equipment struck oil in the Chroma Highlands 50 years ago. Did you get a feel for the Altru history? I think. We have over here the portraits of Altru Inc.'s presidents throughout the years. At the far left is our founder and first president, Doyle M. Hall. His dream became reality in Altru Inc. In the center is our second president, who loved Altru Inc. with all his heart. That will be President Brighton Hall. Should I repeat that? Our second president, Brighton Hall. Could you give it away any more obviously? Brighton! It's spelled B-R-I-G-H-T-O-N. Shall I move on? Okay, chill, Karen. On the right is our current president, Blake Hall. He's a standard bearer, shaping the very future of the Almia region. A nice round of applause, please. Clap, clap, clap. Over three generations of fathers and sons, our presidents have dedicated themselves to the development of energy sources for your bright future. So that diary was written by Altru's second president, Brighton Hall. Let's go back to the Union. Oh my god. We can't just teleport there. We really gotta catch another Staraptor and fly back. Maybe not. Wait. I know that music. Is that music I hear from Altru Park's bandstand? Let's check it out. I know exactly what this is. If we hadn't bumped into these guys last episode, this would have blown my mind right here. Pokemon a go-go! From across the sea, the Fiore-born quadruplets have arrived! If you know us, you're a beloved fan! You knew us as criminal quartet then! But that's all in the past. We've had a change of heart and direction. We've transformed into purveyors of theatrical rock. What's the name of our band? Go Rock Quads! We can't hear you! The Go Rock Quads! Don't be shy, shout it loud and proud.
Go Rock Quads!
You there. I'm grateful for your contributions to our call and response routine, but we're the Go Rock Quads, not Go Rock Squad. This is only a rehearsal, but please don't mess around during our show. The quadruplet family bond, Go Rock Quads. 4 is the magic number for any band. 4 instead of 3. 4 rather than 5. What do you think about this? We've been stressing how we're quads and a 4-piece band and so on. But any which way you look at us, we're a trio, as in only 3 people. It's because Clyde's gone off somewhere. Clyde has some soul searching to do. He's pulling out his hair over the lyrics for that song we're doing at the event. He flipped out when he saw the lyrics Altru sent for the song. He went off ranting and raging that he couldn't sing this stuff. There's plenty of time before the Altru commemoration event. I wouldn't be too concerned. If Big Bro Clyde doesn't come back, we'll have to change our name. What'll we be? The Go Rock Trio? The Go Rock Triplets? Go Rock 3? Are we repeating dialogue from the last episode? So they're the Go Rock Quads. I heard rumors about them when it was back in Fiore. Dude, I love that they're here, and I love the connections to Fiore in this game. Like, it's so minor. Like, it's not a huge connection or anything, but the fact that Keith went there and was being a ranger over there, and now the Go Rock Quads are showing up, and we got to see, like, the temple and everything, Fiore Temple and stuff like that in the Almia Times. I love stuff like that. It just shows that this is one big universe, and that Shadows of Almia takes place in the same world as the first game. Even though it's a different region, it's, you know, it's the same world, and I love stuff like that. I love stuff like that in media in general, so the fact that it's here makes me really appreciate this game. But dude, let me tell you, if we hadn't bumped into the Go Rock Quads in the previous episode, and my first instance of knowing that they were here was them playing that music, I would have lost my mind, let me tell you. Oh god, okay, let's go back to the research room real quick. And, let them know what we figured out, even though I already knew that and didn't really need to go back there. I remembered that that was a thing. Yo, what up, dude? Oh, it's not you, is it? I tried to talk to Hastings? Okay.
What's that you say? Brighton is the second president of Altru. Yes, yes, I remember now, that's true. President Brighton Hall was a rather plain and undistinguished man in appearance. I've no idea where he may live now, or indeed if he is still alive. He's completely slipped from my mind. The conclusion we can reach is that the diary was written by President Brighton.
Yeah. I could have told you that. May I begin my presentation?
Yes, yes, go on.
Very well. President Brighton's diary, we estimate, dates back some 30 years. At the time, it's apparent that the oil field of the Chroma Highlands was running out. Brighton was very concerned about this. But then, Brighton made a huge discovery while drilling a shaft in the oil field. A mysterious, gigantic black stone was found mounted atop a ceremonial dais. That's how you say that, right? I think it is. This, I believe, was what Sven mentioned in his report as the Shadow Crystal. Brighton writes that something in his heart responded to the Shadow Crystal. He says that the crystal embodied an immeasurably vast amount of energy. The diary also touched upon his only child, Blake Hall. Any mention of the present-day Altru president is only in passing, however. Brighton apparently left care of his only son mostly to his wife. He focused his attention on studying the Shadow Crystal. He believes the power of darkness would finally solve Almia's energy problem. And that's all we have so far, unfortunately. We'll continue with our deciphering.
Well done! We're starting to see a connection emerge between the Shadow Crystal and Altru!
Wow, that's amazing! This little black stone's the energy of the future, huh?
What? What is this? What is this?
Murph, your chest, it's shining. What on earth is happening to you?
Murph? Looks pretty.
What's shining isn't Murph after all, it seems. Murph, what are you hiding in your chest?
Now hold on, Professor. I've got nothing to hide. No! What's shining is my pendant.
Damn, he moves fast.
Look here, look at this. Examine the meter readings. The power of the Dark Shard has dropped sharply. What is going on here? Murph, tell us, what exactly is that blue pendant?
My pops gave it to me as a gift. It's a souvenir from Hia Valley. My pa is the leader of a Pokemon research team in Hia Valley. He says this pendant was made by an old lady who lives in Hia Valley. It's made from a blue stone named Tears of Princes.
Ash, don't just stand there. Hop to it at once, chop chop! Hia Valley! Hia Valley it is! Go to Hia Valley and gather information on the Tears of Princes at once! It's a mission! A mission!
Okay! Hastings is very excited about this.
Keith, I need you to stay here to assist me.
Things will only get more hectic now. Ash! Ash! I have to tell you the way to Hia Valley! You step out of the Union HQ and walk south until you reach a river. It's called the Dream River. It's really pretty. You'll want to go up that river and into the cave that leads to Hia Valley. You can see Floatzel near the river around this time of the year. You should get them to help you. Floatzel will carry you upstream if you get on its back from up here. But woohoo, what a surprising turn of events. Imagine me coming up big. I love you, Murph. I really do. See you, Keith. I kind of wish you could come with us again on this mission, bud, but we're top rangers. We gotta do our own stuff. So let's go. Let's head south of here and finally catch Floatzel. We knew that we could use Floatzel a long while back. But now it seems like they're finally gonna become available to us. So I think that's actually the last transportation Pokemon we can get. Doduo, Staraptor, and now Floatzel. So I'm pretty excited about that. Or it's most of them, I know that much. There he is! There's Floatzel! Alright, we have a Bidoof with us, so we'll go ahead and use the Grass-type Poke Assist. It only lasts 9 seconds, but still, it's better than nothing. Don't you dare. Okay, well. Oh god. We're not getting one line, but that was still pretty fast, and we got good Poke Assist. Maybe we'll be fine? Probably not. Floatzel! It spits orbs and blobs of water to attack with the area move River Flow. I'm not too worried about getting S on this guy, because we're definitely going to catch him more than one time. Rapid, good Poke Assist, no damage. Yeah, that's an A. About what I expected. I probably could have waited until the Poke Assist ran out and then got him with Charge Capture, but... oh well. Floatzel, can we get on your back? Well, before we do that... okay, well, never mind. I was gonna say let's go that way. Are these target clearable? No, they're not. Oh, he's spinning his tail! That's cute! That's really cute. Alright, here we go! Up the river we go! This is really pretty. This is a super pretty area. Yo, what up, dude? This is a secret fishing spot that's known only to me. It's fantastic, other than the fact that there's nothing to catch here. Yeah. This is the Krista Cave. When you get through here, you'll find yourself in the icy, chilly Hia Valley. Okay. Here we are, the Krista Cave. Do we have any Pokemon around here, maybe? Oh, okay. It looks like we might actually have two spots we can get off at. Okay, this one's a dead end, so I guess we'll go here first. Let's hop off of Floatzel. Thank you, buddy. I hope there's another one around here. Alright, got a Golbat and a Jigglypuff right there. Okay. Alright, Mr. Golbat. Where's your attack go? Okay, you got Supersonic. I feel like... okay, I thought he was gonna be really fast, but he's not as fast as I initially thought he would be. Oh my god, he's kind of annoying. He's got a poison attack too. Now let's get the charge finish. Maybe. Our line's too long! Damn it. Fine. You know what? Whatever. Whatever, Golbat. You apparently didn't feel like helping out. It lets loose supersonic waves and spits poison to attack, and it has Crush 2. Alrighty. Yeah, B rank. About what I expected. Just about what I expected. Alright, we also got a Jigglypuff, and there's the other Floatzel. Okay. Let's see, Jigs. You know what? I kind of just want to use... Let me get rid of this Golbat. I don't think... I don't know why, he annoyed me. And I guess this also gives us another chance to catch him. To get that S rank. Again, not that we need it, but whatever. Jigglypuff. It attacks by singing to send out musical notes with Tackle 1. Alrighty. No damage 3? Okay. Alrighty. Let's see. Floatzel? Is it just Floatzel around here? I believe it is. We're gonna have to catch him anyway, so we'll scoop him up. And I really don't know if the Golbat will have come back yet. Okay, he just lets out little bubbles. That's easy enough to deal with. Ah, oh, so close. Come on, get it. There we go. That wasn't great. It really wasn't great. We could have definitely gotten the S right there if I was just a little bit better. Yeah, A once again, as expected. Alright, if Golbat's here, we'll catch him again. He's not. Okay, well, that's fine. Come on, Floatzel. Help us out here, bud. And let's head on up this away to the other entrance, or other pier, I guess. Da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-o. There he goes. Alright, got another Floatzel. I guess we'll catch him just so we have him. Because, you know, there could definitely be more water coming up. I'm almost certain that there will be. Damn it, you always run straight for the capture line. I mean, I guess that makes sense. Whichever way he runs, he's running to the capture line, but you get the point. You get what I'm trying to say. Until we have a good poke assist for this guy, I don't think we're gonna be S-ranking him. Another Golbat. Don't really care about you right now. There's a lot of Golbat in here, actually. Alright. Did we want to go to the right first? This Oh, there's a Celio Swinub. I feel like we wanted to go to the right first. This feels like the way to go. The other side feels like dead end territory. So let's do that. Just to be safe, you know. I want to make sure that we don't miss out on any Pokemon. No, you don't. We're much slower than Gligar, so they don't quite catch up with us. Oh, I was definitely right. Okay, Camerupt. Freaking Camerupt in here. Okay. Well, in that case, let me just use this guy real fast. Let me draw myself a big old bubble. Okay, that was just rude. Eh. Didn't really do a whole lot for us, did it? I can't believe he immediately targeted our capture line. You know what? Oh my god, he's still got so much health left. Take that. And take... Okay, I need your stuff to move. Take this! Let me charge. I know he's only got a little bit left, but we might as well get the charge bonus. Boom. Damn, Camerupt. Alright, noted that you're gonna take a little while. Burn 3! It spits embers, and from its back, blobs of fire. You know what? He's got burn 3. I think we're gonna need him. I really do. I think we're gonna hold on to this guy. You know what else we're gonna do? We're gonna grab another Floatzel. We just keep getting, like, a ton of chances to get Floatzels up to S rank. And you know what? Because we haven't used them yet, let's go ahead and show off Krogunk. Touch and hold to form a big poisonous puddle. The target is made tired. I don't believe we've used this Poke Assist yet. So, if we just... Yeah. That works. That didn't work very well, but... Okay. It's kind of nice that you can do that right next to the Pokemon. So if you still- Oh, I'm going the other way. Oh, it feels weird to loop that way. Ew, I didn't like that. So that you can still get one line, technically. That was terrible. You can get the one line bonus, using the Poison Poke Assist, which is pretty nice. Alright, let's just avoid the Golbats and move on. I'm glad we went back. I'm very glad we went back. Alright, Pikachu. Here's Celio. Can we just jump down here? Yeah. Come here, little Celio! Little buddy, old pal. I would like to capture you. I just said Celio, this is Sfeel. We've never used normal Poke Assist, so let's go ahead and do that. Let's get rid of this Eevee. Power is slightly boosted, the capture line is extended. I've never shown this off, but it's literally just a power boost. Oh, we can't use the charge. Interesting. I didn't know that part, but okay. Sfeel! It attacks by spitting hunks of ice with field move tackle. Numero uno. Alrighty. Hey, that's an S rank on the Sphiel. Alright, definitely want to make sure to catch everything in here, of course. I mean, we always want to make sure to catch everything. I will admit, I haven't really spoken about this before. Could you just let me catch you? I haven't really spoken about this before, but, the radar in this game doesn't show you where the Pokemon are. In the first game, all Pokemon in the area were on the radar, so you could kind of get a feel for where they are. I mean, it didn't tell you what they were or anything like that, but it showed you their general location. Swinub! It breathes powdered snow and rams to attack. It likes to do that in the overworld too, as we just learned. Okay then. And that's an S on the Swinub. Oh, okay. Magby, probably not gonna need you. You have Tackle, you have Tackle, you have Tackle. I think, yeah, you have Ice Poke Assist. We haven't used Ice Poke Assist yet, but I imagine it's pretty good. So, actually, we're about to catch a Celio. So, we'll get rid of Sphiel. Let's get rid of Magby and Sphiel. Because if we really want Sphiel back, we can go get him. He's in this room. Here's Celio. I wonder when we're going to catch a Walrein. Do you think we'll catch a Walrein in this mission? Quite possibly. Oh! Okay, I got scared. I got real scared of him just then. Would you charge already? Thank you. There. That was... That could have been one line if I had just been a little bit more patient. Celio, field move Crush 2. It attacks by blowing powdered snow and hunks of ice from its mouth. I honestly thought it was gonna have Tackle, that's why I got rid of Sphiel. But... Oh well. Only an A. Well, I guess if we got one line capture, then we would have gotten that, but... Oh well. We got a Pikachu over here, we don't- Okay, well, fine. Just because you kinda got in the way, I guess we'll catch you. We can recharge the 6 damage we've taken. I definitely thought he was about to hit me and I was gonna eat my words and have to- and, like, heal more than 6 damage, but whatever. Whatever. I'm close to a level up as well. Alright, Pikachu, go ahead. Recharges.
Then get out of here! Get the heck out of here!
Alright, I do believe that's everything in here. There's another Floatzel. Do we wanna- wait, there was a way up, right? Yeah, there was a way out to the top.
Ah, Floatzel!
Okay. Cool. I guess we'll catch another one. Why the heck not, right? It clearly wants to be with us. Give me the S, give me the S, give me the- Damn it, he always runs towards his bubbles. When he runs towards his bubbles, I get scared. Alright, rapid, no damage, yeah, whatever. No biggie. And then, get rid of a Floatzel. I don't think we need to have two right now. Alright, yeah, we'll head this way first. I really don't know which way is gonna be considered the way to go. Because obviously we can go left and right. Or, sorry, up and right, I should say. So, let's check over here. Oh, okay. I really don't know which way would be considered the dead end, but... Is that a Floatzel again? There's another Floatzel. It's so convenient that they're all around here. Oh, Chingling! Okay. Well, we've seen a Chingling before in, Puel Town. Let's go ahead and use Jigglypuff, why not? We've seen a Chingling in Puel Town before. Oh my god. Oh my god. I think I raised my stylus off of the screen by accident. Yeah, we've seen it in Puel Town, but we were never quite able to catch it. It has Teleport as the map move, and it attacks with strange orbs and sounds. It attacked with literal music notes. Alright, rapid capture, no damage. Yeah, kind of expected that. Wasted my freaking Jigglypuff. But no biggie. Let's grab this Floatzel. And then, get out of here, I guess. We'll get the heck on out of here. Alright, I'm ready for you this time. I'm ready. I was ready! What did I tell you? I knew I was ready. That's gotta be S, right? We caught him as he moved. Yes, finally, okay. Alrighty, folks. I think on that note, we are gonna go ahead and call it an episode right here. Next time, we'll be, of course, continuing through the Crista Cave. Hopefully making our way up towards Hia Valley and maybe making it there and finally seeing the little mission accepted little
thing that appears, you know? You know what I'm talking about. I hope you know what I'm talking about. Are we gonna need you again? I'm gonna... No, we're gonna risk not bothering to Okay! Pikachu! I guess we'll catch the Pikachu because it's right here. And because I'm trying to do my outro and Pikachu decided not, I'm gonna be right where you're gonna land. Screw you. Jesus, alright. Level up? Maybe? Nowhere near. Okay. Anyways, as I was saying... Oh, Krogunk's real happy. Next time, we'll be continuing on through the Crystal Cave. Through that little doorway. And seeing just what we find. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like. And of course, let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.